here. Our band ensemble will begin the pre-service music.
Thank you. welcome, and Merry Christmas to you all.
Merry Christmas.
Is it a joyous gathering like this size again in 2 years? 2 years ago we were here. Isn't that good? It's a joyful. Yeah. People that around you that you come with and wish them a Merry Christmas and message too. So Merry Christmas. At Christmas we experience the joy of Jesus, of course, but it's the joy of Jesus that makes us complete. Gathering together helps us to grow together. And it's great to see all these young guys up here all decked out in their Christmas attire. You guys look great. Are you ready to go? Okay, yeah, they are. To grow together in large gatherings, we're going to enjoy this evening as we look forward to family and friends over Christmas holidays celebrating our Savior's birth. The theme of it is Christmas Everywhere. I'm ready to go. I'm ready to absorb this. Are you? All right. Welcome. And I'd like to say thank you to St. Luke for allowing us to use their marvelous facility. You'll see Christmas decorations around the place. There's one out in the lobby, so if you want to take photos afterwards, please hang around and do so. It's a great time to get family photo ops. But without any further ado, I'd like to call Pastor Rago up here to help us to begin with a word of prayer. Pastor Rago.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, tonight you remind us you sent your Son to be the Savior of the world. But you also sent him especially for us. We can pray tonight. Father, thank you for sending Jesus for me. And yet each of us are unique, and you love each one of us uniquely. So we rejoice tonight as you use these children to share this great good news and the gift of Jesus with us tonight. We remember everywhere around the world, you have called people to follow you. Bless us as we hear this great message again. May we rejoice that this great gift of your Son is ours tonight. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Michael. Before we get started, we're going to have an offering, and we're going to change it up this year. It was drawn to our attention, devastating news in the Midwest, Kentucky, those states, those devastating losses that they suffered through tornadoes. Jesus says to love our neighbors as ourselves. Then he says, well, who is your neighbor? It is the people that we know that are in need. We recognize to serve our neighbors. So oftentimes we have an opportunity to share the joy of Jesus with someone else who is recovering or mourning over that devastation down in the middle states there. So that's our offering today. Thank you.
Thank you. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place when Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to his town to register. So Joseph also went out from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born. She gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn.
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel of the Lord said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger."
Suddenly a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angels, praising God and saying, "Glory to the God of the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about."
So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
His true story of the birth of Jesus has influenced the whole world. Everywhere, the story is the same, but believers around the world celebrate the gift in different ways. Please join us on a journey throughout the world as we share the music of Christmas everywhere.
Just imagine, right now people are celebrating Christmas all over the world. The story of Jesus' birth is told in far-off lands where it may be snowing outside and also on tropical islands where palm trees are swaying in the warm breeze.
The wonderful news of Christmas is that Jesus came to bring peace on earth and goodwill to all people. Now we would like to take you on a musical journey to some of these far-off lands and to show you how the joy of Christmas is spread around the world.
Thank you. band carols, known as parandas, visit neighbors or friends singing aguinaldos or Spanish Christmas carols. They often play instruments of dried gourds with seeds inside, called parandas. One of the favorite carols is called En el Puerto Aguilar, or In Bethlehem Square.
Silence. Christmas tree, which is usually put up the morning of Christmas Eve. Only after attending church that evening is the tree lit for the first time.
Christmas is the Lord.
In France, there are many nativity scenes, which they call crèches. The crèche not only includes Mary, Joseph, and baby Jesus, but also little figurines representing